Jazallahu bil khayrati anna a'immatan lana naqalu al-Qur'ana 'azban wa salsala faminhum budurun sab'atun qad tawasatat sama' al-'ula wal-'adl zuhran wa kummala.
In this episode, my beloved brothers and sisters, I'm going to respond to the doubt that was put out there saying that the Qur'an is not mutawatir. This is going to be our fifth response in the claim that the Qur'an is not mutawatir. This response, inshaAllah ta'ala, is going to be al-adillatu al-qati'ah ala tawatur al-Qur'ani bijami'i qira'atihi al-sahiha al-mashhura min ahdi ashabi rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa tabi'ina ila yawmina hadha. I'm going to give clear-cut evidences that the Qur'an is mutawatir in all of its qira'at, which are sahih, that are known, the 10 qira'at, from the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam until this day today. And I have broken the marahil, the stages, into three. In this episode, inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to mention two stages, and in the episode to come after, I will mention the third stage, bi-idhni ilahi al-kareem, as the third stage is the longest. I will mention that one by itself, and bi-idhnillahi al-kareem, we would then have been able to answer the doubt that is put out there, which is that the Qur'an is not mutawatir. So let me start by saying the al-marhalatul-ula is the first stage. The Qur'an has been transmitted from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to his companions through tawatur, mass transmission. Multitude narration. And Imam al-Bukhari narrated in his Sahih on the authority of Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu that Fathu Makkah was the conquest of Makkah. Abdullah ibn Abbas, and he said, and the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam kharaja fi Ramadan, that the Prophet came out in Ramadan min al-Madinah, from the city of Medina, wa ma'ahu ashratul alafi, and with him was what? 10,000. وَذَلِكَ عَلَى رَأْسِ ثَمَانِ سِنِينَ وَنِصْفٍ مِّن مَقْدَمِهِ الْمَدِينَةِ فَصَارَ هُوَ وَمَن مَعْهُ مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ عَلَى مَكَّةِ. This was only 8 years of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam being in Medina. And he came back with 10,000 people to go into Mecca with him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now this is 10,000 men, women who were with the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, 10,000. And this is just one expedition. This is just one ghazwa. After that, what happened? After the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, the conquest of Mecca, did the numbers increase? Of course they increased. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ وَالْفَتْحِ وَرَأَيْتَ النَّاسَ يَدْخُلُونَ فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ أَفْوَاجًا فَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ وَاسْتَغْفِرُهُ إِنَّهُ كَانَ تَوَّابًا. The people who are entering into the religion in large numbers, Allah mentions. يَدْخُلُونَ فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ أَفْوَاجًا. The people were coming into Islam in large numbers. Different tribes, different lands, they were all surrendering to him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they were coming into his religion. Al-Imam Muslim narrated in his Sahih that Ka'b ibn Malik in the Ghazwa of Tabuk, the Battle of Tabuk, he said, غزا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, that the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he participated in the Battle of Tabuk, صلوات الله وسلامه عليه, صلى الله عليه وسلم, بناس كثير يزيدون على عشرة الآلاف ولا يجمعهم ديوان حافظ. That the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, a people were larger than 10,000, more than 10,000, they went with the Prophet ﷺ to the Battle of Tabuk. وَلَا يَجْمَعُهُمْ دِيوَانٌ حَافِظٌ. And there could have not been a record to record them. And the number was too large. 10,000, there was no way someone could keep a record of them. There's not a book that could have registered these people. It's too large in number, 10,000. حافظ ابن حجر رحمه الله, in the muqaddimah of his kitab, Al-Isaba fi Tamiz al-Sahaba, Ibn Hajar has a kitab called Al-Isaba fi Tamyiz al-Sahaba. There are three good books when it comes to the companions. If you want to read about the companions, one is Al-Isaba fi Tamyiz al-Sahaba, written by Ibn Hajar. There's the Kitab Usudul Ghaba by Ibn Athir. And the third one is Al-Isti'ab by Ibn Abdul Barr. These three books are very good when it comes to the companions. And without a doubt, Ibn Hajar's one is the best. Ibn Hajar says in the muqaddimah of his kitab, Al-Isaba fi Tamyiz al-Sahaba, he said, فَجَمَعْتُ كِتَابًا كَبِيرًا فِي ذَلِكَ مَيَّزْتُ فِيهِ الصَّحَابَةً مِّنْ غَيْرِهِمْ وَمَعَ ذَلِكَ فَلَمْ يَحْصُلْ لَنَا مِنْ ذَلِكَ جَمِيعًا الْوُقُوفِ عَلَى الْعُشْرِ مِنْ أَسَامِ الصَّحَابَةِ. Ibn Hajar says, I've combined a book, a very big book, and it's up as volumes, in the companions and who they are. He talks about each companion. مَيَّزْتُ فِيهِ الصَّحَابَةِ, I distinguish the companions from who the ones that are not companions, who are companions and who are not companions. فَلَمْ يَحْصُلْ لَنَا مِنْ ذَلِكَ, he said, I wasn't able to stand over جَمِيعًا, all of those companions. الْوُقُوفْ عَلَى الْعُشْرِ مِنْ أَسَامِي, I couldn't stand over 1/10 of the companions. I mean, the large number they were. And then Ibn Hajar rahimahullah, he said, الْوُقُوفْ عَلَى الْعُشْرِ مِنْ أَسَامِ الصَّحَابَةِ بِالنِّسْبَةِ إِلَى مَا جَاءَ عَنْ أَبِي زُرْعَةَ الرَّازِي, in comparison to the Sahabas that have been mentioned by Abu Zur'at al-Razi, Ibn Hajar is saying, I don't have 1/10 of the companions that were mentioned by Abu Zur'at al-Razi. And the number of companions that I've mentioned in the Kitab al-Isaba fi Tamyiz al-Sahaba is not 1/10. Compared to what? Compared to the people that were mentioned by Abu Zur'at al-Razi. What were the people that Abu Zur'at al-Razi mentioned? And what was the number that he mentioned? Abu Zur'at al-Razi said, تُوُفِّيَ النَّبِي, the Prophet died. وَمَنْ رَآهُ وَسَمِعَ مِنْهُ, the people who heard from the Prophet, the people who narrated from the Prophet ﷺ, are عَلَى مِئَةِ أَلْفِ إِنسَانِ. He said, تُوُفِّيَ النَّبِي صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet died. وَمَنْ رَآهُ وَسَمِعَ مِنْهُ زِيَادَ عَلَى مِئَةِ أَلْفِ إِنسَانٍ. When the Prophet died عليه الصلاة والسلام, the people who saw the Prophet and also heard from the Prophet and heard from the Prophet are more than 100,000. من رجل ومرأة, men and women, كلهم قد روى عنه سماعا أو رؤيا, all of them have narrated from him, they've seen him, and they mentioned from him. 100,000, Abu Zur'a al-Razi saying more than 100,000. Then I was taken back when I stood over the statement of Ibn Futuh. He has a dayl on the isti'aba Ibn Abdul Barr. He says, after he mentioned the statement of Abu Zur'at al-Razi, Ibn Hajar referenced Ibn Futuh, where he said in his kitab isti'ab, he said, أجاب أبو زرعة بهذا السؤال من سأله عن الرواة خاصة فكيف بغيرهم. Abu Zur'at al-Razi was responding to someone who said to him, how many people narrated from the Prophet? And Abu Zur'at al-Razi said 100,000, more than 100,000. So these are the people who narrated from him. They're not just the Sahabas who saw the Prophet. I mean, there's people who heard and narrated from him, and there's people who saw him but didn't narrate from him. And they heard from him, but they didn't choose to narrate on behalf of the Prophet. They chose not to. Not everybody had to. So which one is going to be more? The ones who sit down to teach the people about what the Prophet said and what the Prophet did. If they are 100,000, then what about those who didn't narrate from him, alayhi salatu wasalam, who saw him? So the companions are large in number. Hafidh ibn Hajar, all of this which I'm mentioning, I'm taking it from Hafidh ibn Hajar's muqaddimah in his kitab al-Isaba fi Tamyiz al-Sahaba. He says, قُلْتُ, this is Ibn Hajar, وَقَرَأْتُ بِخَطِّ الْحَافِذِ الذَّهَبِي مِنْ ظَهْرِ كِتَابِهِ التَّجْرِيدِ. Ibn Hajar is saying, I read with the handwriting of Imam al-Dhahabi, I read from his own handwriting, on the cover of the kitab al-Tajrid, that he said, يعني the مقدمه, أن جميع من في أسود الغابة 7,554 نفسا, ومما يؤيد قول أبي زرعة ما ثبت في الصحيحين من حديث كعب بن مالك في قصة تبوك, والناس كثير لا يحصيهم ديوان, انتهى كلامه. يعني كلام حافظ ابن حجر. Ibn Hajar says, I read with the handwriting of Imam al-Dhahabi that he mentioned in his kitab al-Tajrid, أن جميع من في أسود الغابة, this kitab أسود الغابة, the people that are in there are what? 7,554. That's how much is mentioned in the Kitab Usudul Ghaba. وَمِمَّا يُؤَيِّدُ قَوْلَ أَبِي زُرْعَى. And this is what supports the statement of Abu Zur'a, is that which is found in Bukhari and Muslim. That Ka'b ibn Malik, what did he say? In the story of the Tabuk, وَالنَّاسُ كَثِيرُ لَا يُحْسِيهِمْ دِوَانُ. That the people are so much, there was no one able to number them. يعني, when Ka'b ibn Malik said about the battle of Tabuk, that the people and the companions were so large, they, no diwan, يعني, no record book can keep their names, so much. This is what supports Abu Zur'a's Tazarrazi statement, Hafiz Mahajiri say. Khulasa. Summary of what I'm trying to mention. What I'm trying to mention is that the Sahabis who took from the Prophet, who narrated from the Prophet, are more than 100,000. Let's say 1,000 people narrated from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam the different qira'at al-sahiha al-mashhura. 1,000, 1,000 who we say they heard the qira'at from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the authentic qira'at from the Prophet alaihi wasallam. Okay, they heard from him. How much? يعني, we have 1,000. I said we have 1,000. 100 heard one qira'ah. The second 100 heard another qira'ah. The third 100 had another qira'ah. وَهَلُوا مَجَرَّ. And their 10 qira'at came through 100 people each. Is that not حَدُّ التَّوَاتُر? Is that not multitude? Is that not mass transmission? I'm being very little. I'm just saying 100. We have 100,000. We just said 100 narrated the qira'ah of Ibn Amir. 100 narrated the qira'ah of Ibn Kathir. 100 narrated the qira'ah of Nafi'. 100 narrated the qira'ah of Kisa'i. And 100 narrated the qira'ah of Abi Amr. And each 100 each. We won't go overboard. Would that not be mass transmission? Of course it would be mass transmission. Now I'm going to move on to the second marhala, the second stage, which is the companions passing on to their students, the tabi'in. We have, the Prophet has a large number of companions, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was commanded to convey this Qur'an. يَا أَيُّهَا الرَّسُولُ بَلِّغْ مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ رَبِّكَ وَإِنْ لَمْ تَفْعَلْ فَمَا بَلَّغْتَ رِسَالَتْ وَاللَّهُ يَعْصِمُكَ مِنَ النَّاسِ. The Prophet was commanded to convey this message. فَصْدَعْ بِمَا تُؤْمَرْ وَعَرِضْ عَنِ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. Muhammad, turn away from these disbelievers and those people who are trying to harm you. Just convey your message. Convey this message of Islam. إِنَّمَا عَلَيْكَ الْبَلَاغُ. Upon you is to convey. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, without a shadow of a doubt, he conveyed the Quran to these people. Okay? He conveyed the wording and the meaning to the Sahabas. 100,000, we already established that they have narrated from the Prophet ﷺ. They took from the Prophet ﷺ. They conveyed on behalf of the Prophet ﷺ. That is what? That is the Prophet to his companions. Now we're moving on to the companions to their students. I'm only going to give one example. But we can do the same for the rest. But just one example. We have the Qari whose name is Ibn Amir. Ibn Amir is the Qari of the people of Sham. لِذَلِكَ شَاطِبِي, he says, وَأَمَّا دِمَشْقُ الشَّامِ دَارُ ابْنُ عَامِرٍ فَتِلْكَ بِعَبْدِ اللَّهِ طَابَتْ مُحَلَّلًا هِشَامٌ وَعَبْدُ اللَّهِ وَهُوَ انْتِسَابُهُ لِذَكْوَانَ بِالْإِسْنَادِ عَنْهُ تَنَقَّلًا. So, وَأَمَّا دِمَشْقُ الشَّامِ دَارُ ابْنُ عَامِرٍ فَتِلْكَ بِعَبْدِ اللَّهِ طَابَتْ مُحَلَّلًا. Ibn Amir, he's the Qari of the people of Sham. Let's look at him. Al-Imam Al-Hafidh Ibn Asakir, he has a mawsu'a called Tarikh al-Dimashq. Tarikh al-Dimashq. With a sanad, a chain which is authentic. An Abi Ubaidullah Muslim Ibn Mikshamin. That he said. Ibn Mikshamin is saying this. Qala li Abu Darda. Abu Darda one day said to me. Abu Darda is the Prophet's companion. Abu Darda said to Ibn Mikshamin, يعني أبي عبيد الله مسلم ابن مكشمين, he said to him, أعدد من يقرأ عندنا. Go and count the people who read on us. Pay attention to this. The people who read the Quran on us, who we listen to their recitation, and we correct their recitation, and we teach the Quran to, count my Quran students. That's what he said to him. Abu Ubaidullah, he stood up. He said, فَعَدَدْتُ أَلْفًا وَسِتَّمِئَةٍ. I counted 1,600. Abu Darda was teaching 1,600 students. وَنَيِّفًا and something. Just round it off to 1,600. And 1,600 and something. Just round it off to 1,600. فَكَانُوا يَقْرَؤُونَ وَيَتَسَابَقُونَ. They would compete with one another. They would read the Qur'an. Then he said, Abu Darda, wa kana Abu Darda qa'iman. Abu Darda would stand over them, he would listen to the recitation, he would correct them, he would say, this is wrong, this is right, say it like this. He would go to the next group of people and he would correct them like that. Wa kana Abu Darda radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he would do this daily. And every day he would sit down and he would teach the Quran. People would come, they would read on him, they would leave. But one gathering of his would be 1,600. And from the people who took from him was, from the people that took from him, that read on him, that took the Quran from him was, وَكَانَ ابْنُ عَامِرٍ مُقَدَّمًا فِيهِمْ. Ibn Amir, the Qari I just mentioned, from the seven Qurra, he was the student of Abu Darda, and he was the respected one amongst them. But 1,600 people were studying with Abu Darda. Ibn Amir is only one of them. So Ibn Amir has with him 1,599 people who took the Qur'an with him. But we call this the qira'ah of who? The qira'ah of Ibn Amir. Not because Ibn Amir is the only one. No, he's got other students. He's got other friends that took it with him. But he's the only one that's mentioned. He's the only one that's mentioned. When we say the qira'at, we attribute it to one. Because he became famous for it. He also came out to teach it and spent his time and his energy and his effort in spreading it. It doesn't mean that no one else took with him. Now, brothers and sisters, Ibn Amir is only one of the Qurra'i Sab'ah. In one gathering of his, there are more than 1,600 people who are studying the Qur'an with him. I now want to ask four questions, just four questions, to those who say the Qur'an is not mutawatir. The first question I want to ask is, if Ibn Amir, in one gathering of his, that he's learning the Qur'an, the people who are participating with him and are also studying the Qur'an with him are more than 1,600, how many people took the Qur'an with Ibn Amir in the whole entire time that he was in Sham? And we're just looking at one gathering of Abu Darda. Abu Darda was not the only person teaching the Qur'an in Sham. There were other Sahabas who were teaching in Sham. There are also other students that were learning in Sham. How many, just one place that Ibn Amir was learning in, 1,600 people were with him. 1,599. What about the other Sahabas who were teaching and their students? How much would they be? Ponder over that. Number, second question I want to ask is, if one Sahabi, taught the Qur'an to 1,600 people, Abu Darda. Just taught 1,600. Then my question to you is, and he made them memorize the Qur'an, and they became Huffaz. How many Tabi'een were taught the Qur'an by the 1,000 that we agreed upon that we would take from the companions? The 1,000 companions who sat down to teach the Qur'an. How many students did they teach? It's just Abu Darda by himself to 1,600 students. I would personally say we're talking about the millions. And if not, we're talking about 100,000, 200,000, 300,000. But I leave the answer to you. Question three, inshallah ta'ala, is that can then someone really come out, brothers and sisters, and claim that the number of companions who took the Quran from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his different qira'at are not mutawatir? The fourth question I want to ask is, can someone really come now and then say the number of tabi'een who took the Qur'an from the Sahabas, the different qira'at, haven't reached haddu tawatur, the level of tawatur, al-mufidu lil-yaqeen, that benefits our certainty? These are four honest questions that we need to ask ourselves. I haven't finished. I have the third marhala to go in, inshallah ta'ala, and to prove more. By the way, I'm summarizing everything. I'm just trying to bring you a summarized information. We could go through names, but the time doesn't allow that. Jazakumullahu khairan for listening to me. I will see you guys inshallah ta'ala in the next episode. Bi'idhnillahi al-kareem. Anything I might have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. BarakAllahu feekum wa jazakumullahu khairan.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.